स्वभाव चिन्मयानन्दं कृपापूर्णं जगत्पतिं हरिषड्वर्गजेतारं नित्यानन्दगुरुं भजे।
लेट्स एंटर इनटू द नेक्स्ट सूत्र। फोकस ऑन फायर राइजिंग थ्रू युअर फॉर्म फ्रॉम द टोस अप अंटिल द बॉडी बर्न्स टू एशेस बट नॉट यू। This is again one of my favorite technique, because one of my predecessor, Ramana Maharshi, became enlightened through this technique. Let me describe Ramana Maharshi's experience in his own words, then you can understand this technique. He says, around the age of 16, suddenly one day, very strong feeling or the fear of death started happening in him. 16-year-old boy, fear of death means, first thing what we would have done, hey, call doctor, we would have shouted 911, this, that, everything. Of course, fortunately in India, no 911 and nothing can be called. And he was not even bothered or perturbed. He did not even bother about calling or telling the family or even the relatives who are there in the same house. He was in Madurai at that time. Just he stretched his body straight and decided to go through the experience. He just lie down like a dead body and started seeing what is going on inside. Understand? A very courageous decision. Very courageous decision. He says beautifully, I saw very clearly I was dying. Step by step, slowly the body died. Suddenly I remembered, yes, only body is dead. I am alive. I exist still. I am there. And he says in the experience he saw very clearly, as if his body being carried, burnt, reduced to ashes, everything happened. In few chana, few seconds, everything happened. But suddenly he says something opened, clicked. Yes, body has disappeared. I died. It is burnt. Everything is over. But I exist. I exist. I am not dead. This was such a strong experience. Bhagavan says, once for all, the death fear left me. The fear of death has left me. And that experience, I exist, stayed forever. Once for all. Understand? In half an hour, you can become enlightened. That is what Bhagavan is saying by expressing this. All it takes is half an hour. Logical mind, an ordinary mind, very difficult for the mind to understand. How can just one simple experience give so much of clarity and courage? An experience transform the whole life. He says within that experience, after that experience happened, within few days he left the house all alone and traveled and came and settled in Arunachala and never left the Arunachala after that. Maybe Ramana Maharshi should have practiced this technique for many janmas before that birth. Whatever he practiced, that experience only just automatically opened up. Opened up and pulled him inside and gave the truth. Let me repeat the sutra and we will try to understand. Focus on fire rising through your form, from the toes up, until the body burns to ashes, but not you. It's a very, I can say practically all mystical tradition in the planet Earth use this technique, including Christianity and Sufism. Even in Christianity, they use this technique. In many Catholic monasteries and nunneries, they use this technique. I read the other day, one of the esoteric Christian groups, spiritual groups, not the social group, but spiritual group, who are fully engaged in transforming them and enlightenment science. Spiritual group. They say that they are nuns. Every day they will lie down inside the coffin before sleeping for 2 hours. Of course, open coffin, not closed. They will lie down and meditate that they are dead. In Sufism, they dig a pit and lie down in that and meditate. Of course, in Vedanta, this is one of the, I can say that most used technique in Vedanta for enlightenment is this death meditation. Kathopanishad describes this technique wonderfully. Most used technique in Vedanta, everybody before taking sannyas has to go through this technique. And in Buddhism, anybody who is initiated into sannyas, first thing he has to do is he has to go and sit in the graveyard for 3 months and see continuously dead bodies being burnt and visualize that he is also being burnt. If you have that much courage, it's good. You can go and sit in graveyard and see the dead bodies being burnt every day. Of course, unfortunately, here in this country, you can't see. It's all electrical. In India, you can see it's an open burning. Natural process. They will arrange the wood and put the body and burn. I have seen, I myself personally had this experience in Varanasi. Let me describe this sutra, then I'll add my personal experience. Focus on fire rising through your form from the toes up until the body burns to ashes, but not you. Mahadeva says, visualize the fire rising out of your body, slowly, step by step, step by step. Let your form be burnt. He's saying beautifully. Let your form be burnt. Let your body turn into ashes, but not you. Let me describe exactly what happened with me when I had experience with this technique. I always used to think I should have the experience of death or face death directly, face to face. But somehow that thought never became a priority. See, any thought has to become priority. Only then experience can happen. If it is just in corner of one mind like a 100 and work, it should become priority in your laundry list. Not last, it should become priority. Usually in our laundry list, washing, cleaning and cleaning the house and paying the rent and phone bill. If time permits, enlightenment also. If time permits, meditation also. That's all. But here, that way, things will not work. Only when it becomes top priority, when urge becomes urgent, things starts transforming in you. Otherwise, it is okay, but nothing much can be done. One small story, one guy goes to the doctor and says, "Doctor, I tried to commit suicide by taking 1,000 aspirins. Doctor asks, "What happened?" Says, no, no, after two I felt better, I stopped. So, you may feel better after two aspirins, if it is in your laundry list. But only if it is in top priority, experience can be achieved. So it was not in my top priority. Somehow it was getting postponed. When I went to Varanasi, Varanasi is the holy city for Hindus, largest floating populated city, floating population. 300,000 people per day enter and go out. Such huge floating population per day, average. That is the amazing thing. And per day, 300 people are burnt in one place. 300 dead bodies are burnt in one place. Manikarniga Ghat, they call it Manikarniga Ghat, where traditionally it is believed, if you leave the body, or if somebody dies in that area, or if somebody's body is burnt in that area, they will be liberated. They will have direct enlightenment. Not only it is traditional belief, Ramakrishna confirms it from his own experience. He says that, I saw very clearly Shiva Mahadeva himself going near every pyre and taking that soul, unclutching it from the body mind and liberating. He says, I saw it with my own experience. So, you can't say it's a mythological belief. It's a solid experience. I had the fortune of going to that ghat. Understand, traditionally, not only it is believed, it is true, for last 2000 years, the fire has never been put off. Whether it rains or shines, flood or whatever it is, they will not bring fire when they come to the Manikarniga Ghat with a dead body. From the pyre, the fire will be taken and lit. It's a akanda smashana, means unbroken fire. Means day and night bodies will be getting supplied. I saw sometime they do bunker cart system, 2-3 bodies at a time. Because so much bodies are coming. I don't know from where people are dying so much. Because if you sit half an hour, something like a 200 bodies comes. And especially in the evenings, because from around the place whoever dies, they will start walking from their place carrying the body. Ram Naam Satya Hai, Ram Naam Satya Hai, that is the mantra they will chant and walk. By the time it becomes evening, they will reach the Manikarniga. Totally per day average 300 bodies are burnt. Only in the evening 200 bodies will be there. Because evening only they will all reach the Manikarniga. Whatever is said and done, I cannot describe experience verbally. Only you have to see there to have that experience. To tell you honestly, the fear of death just disappeared. When you see so many bodies, are what is there? Like this only I am also going to go, okay. You feel there is so many people giving company. You don't feel lonely about death. You feel it's like one more trip. Are so many people are there. Chala, it's okay. And this is what is going to happen. See, if you see one body being burnt rarely once in a while, you will have that fear. There you will see unimaginable. And no ritual, nothing. They will bring the body. Straight they will dip into Ganga. 3 times, Ram Naam Satya Hai, Ram Naam Satya Hai, Ram Naam Satya Hai, over. Means, Rama's name is the ultimate truth. Rama's name is the only eternal truth. Rama's name is the only eternal truth. They will remember this 3 times. Put the body into the water. Just bring it out and keep. By the time the pyre will be ready. The wood will be arranged, ready. Actually, they continuously keep on arranging. Even if bodies are not coming, they are keeping on continuously arranging. I asked them, why do you guys arrange continuously? You don't know, Swamiji, in half an hour, 200 will come. They have accounts as if they know for sure. And the bodies come and it's arranged. They give like a token based on the entry. The moment body enters, they'll give the token. And another one funny thing, no relatives stay there and do any ritual. The moment they do the Ramnam Satyahe, Ramnam Satyahe, dip 3 times to the Ganga and throw the body there and go away, that's all. Because the people who are there, the maintaining, they will take care. And you don't know how long it will take the body which you brought, your friend or relative's body, to be put in the fire. It's in the queue system. Continuously it's going on. All I did, let me try to sit here and see what goes on. And I sat. Just in 1 hour, 1 hour, the death is no more a strange incident which happens once in a while for some relative or friend. It became like a, okay, next, that's all. Next, that's all. All size, all gender, all age, all kinds, all color, all community, all religion also. Anyhow, these guys are seekers. So even they bring the bodies. Even their bodies are brought. All kinds. When continuously you see this happening, you actually lose respect for death. Now you have too much respect, too much of ideas about it. Array, it is nothing. The breath which went inside did not come out. That's all. And chalo. The people who are sitting, waiting for the property, are enjoying. Over. That's all. What is there? And nothing much. Neither anything can be done about it, nor anything can be repented. Now, what is there? Over. Neither you can fast forward, nor you can rewind. Over. And when I saw that bodies being burnt continuously, initially the little fear which was there disappeared. And slowly, not only fear, it became interest. I started going near and started helping them. Helping them. Then slowly I started thinking, after all, this body is also going to become like this. Yes, over. When you remember that death is going to happen to you, the respect which you carry for your ego will come down. Because whatever you think should not leave you is ego. When you know for sure everything is going to leave you, then the respect for ego just drastically drops. And especially, I'm a kind of a too sharp, straightforward guy. So straight away the respect for ego dropped. Then I decided, after all, I'm going to die. Either I should have a death experience now itself and live without the death fear, or die and see. That's all. But I have to see the death. There is a small Shiva temple in one corner and a small tower above the temple. I went and sat in that tower so that nobody will disturb me. In one corner I sat. If you see in the biography souvenir, you will see the photograph where I had the first death experience. I sat there. From there I started seeing the dead bodies being burnt. Still I remember the strong click was when an elderly lady's body was being burnt. I saw her, she had a big belly, the cloth burnt and the fat which was there in the belly started burning and melting and flowing. Sorry for describing too vividly. I could see very clearly, because the cloth got burnt, the body is there and the fat is burning and melting and flowing. Because the fat is flowing, the fire is still burning with a full speed. That gave a very strong click into me. and said, oh God, yes, same way it is going to burn. And same thing is going to happen to this body also. Let it happen. That click opened up a deep fear of death. And that fear, when it spread all over the body, when I faced it consciously, I could see very clearly that fear spreading all over the body. When the fear met my awareness, hit my awareness, that became death experience. Understand? Whenever your fear is suppressed, it stays inside you as a suppressed fear. Whenever it comes out and you are not consciously facing it, it becomes a fear stroke and shakes your whole nervous system and breaks it down. If it is faced consciously, it becomes death experience. The fear, death fear, if you just escape, run away, when that fear happens, it becomes death. When you face it consciously, it becomes death experience. Death fear plus subconscious is suppression. Death fear plus unconscious is nervous breakdown. Death fear plus conscious is death experience. Understand? I have given a clear explanation, clear equation. Death fear plus subconscious is suppression, perversion. Death fear plus unconscious means you don't suppress, but neither you face. You just get shaken, frightened. Fear stroke, nervous breakdown. Death fear, conscious awareness is death experience. I was able to see very clearly the fear which rose when I faced it consciously with awareness became death experience. Means I saw clearly the body is dead. It's not moving. 2.5 days. No food, no water, no thought, no question, no doubt, body was there. Only after the experience I realized 2.5 days passed. It was there. I could see with closed eyes, the body is dead and there is no movement. Suddenly, after 2.5 days, the click happened. God, body is dead, but I exist still. I am there. That clarity, that click, when it clicked, it became such an intense ecstasy. The fear of death left once for all. And it has become such a deep ecstasy, such a joy, such bliss. And slowly opened the eyes. I was able to move the body. First thing I felt was such a deep ecstasy and gratitude. I went down to the Ganga. It was just a few feet. Sprinkled little Ganga water. Took the Ganga water in Kamandalu, little ash from the pyre, straight went to Vishwanatha and put that ash and did the puja. That was the first thing. It was such a deep gratitude. I saw Vishwanatha was alive. Understand? Because I died, Vishwanatha became alive. Till the day before, because I was alive, Vishwanatha was always dead stone. Because I was alive, Vishwanatha was just dead stone. Because I died, Vishwanatha is the Shiva in Varanasi, the Shivalinga. I always felt to touch this stone, 300,000 people are coming every day. What foolishness! And one more funny thing, when you can touch the deity by yourself, you lose respect. In South India, you can't touch. In North India, you can touch by yourself. And Vishwanatha, you can touch and play with yourself, everything. And naturally, you will feel, what is this? Just to touch this stone, people are coming from all the way. I always felt it was a stone. Because I was alive. When I died, I saw clearly, he is alive. Only one can be alive, either him or you. When you see the truth, he will become alive. We will not be anymore alive as we think. And the fear of death left once for all. I can say, this is one of the very strong experience transformed me towards my enlightenment, towards the spiritual ultimate truth. That click is what I call Satori, the enlightenment experience. Let you achieve and radiate the eternal bliss, Nityananda. Thank you.